Jesus says, if I be lifted up, I will draw all men unto myself. And for 18 years, I've held fast to that scripture. To reach out to people of all ages, color barriers, no matter what their social background is, I wanted to make it so that anybody who wanted to could come and hear the gospel of Jesus Christ. To unite the generations and the denominations. That's exactly what the Lord put in my spirit so many years ago. But in order to put that together, it took a crew of 33 men working literally all day long just to make sure that it was perfect for everybody when they walked through the doors. We tried so hard to please them. And when it was all said and done, we knew that they were ministered to. These guys left the normalcies of their lives, their families, wives, kids, because Jesus says, if you love me, feed my sheep. And each one of these guys loved the Lord. Just to give you an idea of some of the things we've been involved in, we wanted to do an outreach to the city of Detroit. We knew of some of the problems they were having in the inner city, gangs, violence. So we went to the Pontiac Silver Dome, Pontiac, Michigan, which is just outside of Detroit. We did a concert free of charge, threw open the doors so that anybody who wanted to could come. And over 30,000 young people filled that place to hear Jesus Christ as Lord. But it didn't stop there for us. We wanted to be a witness wherever a witness was needed. And to me, that was at spring break in Daytona Beach, Florida. Now, I don't know if you realize this, but spring break is a parent's worst nightmare. Nearly 400 colleges and high schools empty out across the United States, and they go down to Daytona Beach, and for a few weeks, it's nothing but sex, drugs, rock and roll, AIDS, suicide, rape, you name it, it happens. We set up right on the beach, right between Playboy and MTV, and we preached Jesus to them all night long. Thousands of lives were changed. One of the most violent places in our country is called Fort Apache in the Bronx, appropriately named because of the high crime rate. The police department was worried that the gangs would begin to formulate, so they sent out 200 police officers on foot and on horseback to surround the park in case any problems broke out. Well, there was not one incident reported. As a matter of fact, we had time left over to lead many of the police officers to the Lord that day. The first ever gospel concert of its kind in Barbados. They never had anything like this happen in their country. But they says, pray that it doesn't rain. They're very superstitious. If it rains, they won't come. It did nothing but rain. However, they came with their umbrellas down to the altar to receive Jesus Christ as Lord. Wanderers Cricket Stadium, Johannesburg, South Africa. God had put it in my spirit 18 years before to see stadiums filled with people worshiping the Lord. We actually had to go outside of our country to see this happen for the very first time. I went to that stadium when I was on tour in Africa and walked the perimeters of it, claiming it for the glory of God. It was 1 year later that 50,000 people came to hear the gospel of Jesus Christ set to music. That stadium had never been used for any musical purposes prior to that. Even Nelson Mandela came to that event. But nothing compared to seeing this kind of response to the gospel happen in my home country, the United States of America. God put it in my spirit to do a concert crusade at, of all places, Texas Stadium. The thought of that larger-than-life venue filled with people of all ages worshiping the Lord was just intoxicating. But after 12 months of planning, 4,000 volunteers, and innumerable hours of prayer, on October 22, 1994, 71,132 people filled the enormous and legendary Texas Stadium, making it the largest Christian concert ever. People of all ages will come and worship the Lord at these concerts. Folks that have never felt the presence of God in their lives will come, and many for the very first time worship the Lord openly and unashamedly. For nearly two decades, I've never compromised the gospel of Jesus Christ, never taken Jesus out. And I never will.
sits on the throne. God is strong in battle. God is God alone. God is a wise and merciful. God is sovereign Lord. God is pure and holy. God reigns forevermore. He's a great God, a righteous King, a ruler over everything. He's a great God. We will proclaim honor and glory to His name. God holds up the universe. God sustains the soul. God exalts, God puts down. How many know that God is in control? God's glory is eternal. God is love and grace. God knows all, sees all, is all, and God is to be praised. He's a great God, a righteous King, a ruler over everything. He's a great God. Glory and wisdom, thanksgiving and honor and power and might be to our God forever and ever. And all the saints said, holy,
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 holy is His name. God is a God of righteousness, and He sits on the throne, and He is enthroned on the throne of your heart. Let me hear somebody say with me, great God.
Great God.
If you're not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ, but you know that it's the power of God unto salvation, let me hear somebody say tonight, great God.
Great God.
If you're not ashamed of the gospel, and you're ready to put on the garments of praise for the spirit of heaviness, lift your hands, lift your voice, sing.
He's a great God, a righteous King, a ruler over everything.
He's a great God.
We will proclaim honor and glory to His name. A righteous King, a ruler over everything.
He's a great God.
We will proclaim honor and glory to His name. A righteous King, ruler over everything. Great God. We will proclaim honor and glory to His name. A righteous King, a ruler over everything.
He's a great God.
We will proclaim honor and glory to His name. Great God.
Is Jesus the best thing that's ever happened to you here tonight? If you're ready to praise the Lord, I'm ready. But first of all, I want to introduce you to our dancers. Would you please welcome, originally from Charlotte, North Carolina, we call him Slice D. Give it up one time for Darius West, everybody. Darius. This homie over here with the clean haircut, he's from Detroit, Michigan. We call him Slinky. Give a warm welcome to Jamar Davis, everybody. This brother got some Indian blood in him, so we call him Mr. Lightfoot. Give it up one time from Tulsa, Oklahoma, Brian Lemons, everyone. Up now, y'all. I'm gonna try to reach it.
class is now in session. Pay attention to the teacher. We're going through the book, Genesis to Revelation. I'll teach your head how to spread salvation to the nation. We'll start off with the basics, a checklist for the saints. You love the Lord with all your heart and mind and soul and strength. To fear the Lord is wisdom, to serve the Lord divine. But to really break it down, just repeat these words of mine. Say, I love Jesus.
I love Jesus.
Yes, I do. How about you? Everybody, I love Jesus. Yes, I do. Come on.
I love Jesus.
How about you? Grab your pen and paper. The lesson now begins. First up, church artillery. We at war with sin. God trains us to evangelists, apostles, prophets too. Pastors, teachers, five and all. We got work to do. Discernment, tongues, interpretation, prophecy, and faith. Wisdom, knowledge, healing, miracles. Yeah, those are great. These gifts are like atomic bombs. They make the word explode. But they just don't mean nothing unless you know the code. That code is I love Jesus.
I love Jesus.
Yes, I do. Question, are there any ladies in the house here tonight? No, I'm talking about girls that are on fire for the Lord. Are you here? I'm talking about women that are not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ. Are you here? All right, girls, long, loud, and strong, let me hear. Say, I love Jesus. Yes, I do. Hey, where's all the men out here tonight? Where are the men? Where are the men? No, I'm talking about men that are radically saved. Are you here? Men that are champions for God. Are you here? Men that want to beat up on the devil. Are you here? Men that think you can do better than the girls. Are you here?
Yes, I do.
How about you?
I love Jesus.
I love Jesus.
In the center of the caverns of hell, hidden under layers of evil that have thrived for centuries, sits the morbid domain of the Prince of the Power of the Air. Suddenly, a scaly creature disrupts Satan's ghastly existence with an urgent message, and it reads, Code Red Problem, Conference Needed, Disaster Forecasted. With a disgust and annoyance, this General of Evil agrees to confer with his Chief Demon Lieutenant. This is the story of that encounter.
You may enter.
My Lord Satan.
State your business and make it fast.
Sir, we're having problems of cataclysmic proportions.
Where?
In the East Sector, sir. The damage is vast.
Is there something wrong with my abortion clinics?
Oh, no, sir. That's all fine. We kill 4,000 unborn a day through, shall we say, surgical removal?
Good.
It's selective breeding. We eliminate human life in the name of convenience. Like the Nazis and the Jews and with the government's approval.
Is there a problem with my pet project, television violence?
Sir, it's covered from videos to cartoons. By the time a child graduates high school, he's seen 70,000 murders.
Is this effective enough?
Sir, just watch the news.
Is there a disturbance in my false religion?
Oh, no, sir. Business is booming. Over 40 million are into New Age and Zen.
Good.
Over 45 million believe in astrology.
Looks like we are catching up.
Yes, sir. Only 50 million now claim to be born again.
Is there a problem with business in general?
Sir, we're showing tremendous progress.
Yeah.
Teenage runaways each year, a million or more. There's a teen suicide every 90 minutes. And your specialty, drunk driving,
yes,
will claim more lives this year than the whole Vietnam War.
Well, is there a disturbance? What was that?
So that's the reason all these demons are on crutches and wobbling.
What's going on?
So that's what I've been trying to tell you.
What is that?
Sir, that is our problem.
Only one thing causes warfare of this magnitude.
Then, sir, you know what we are dealing with up there.
Yes, it's some of those sanctified.
I try, blood-bought.
Spirit feeding.
Saints of God.
Actually.
Presently on their knees in prayer. Terrors. They bind us, cast us out. Then they do those disgusting, charismatic jigs. They quote scriptures like the Son of God, and sir, if you don't intervene, we all might wind up in a bunch of pigs. Sir, that's the good news. The bad news is the subject of their prayers that threatens our survival. What they're praying for is causing hemorrhaging in the realms of darkness.
And the bad news is...
Well, sir, they're praying for revival!
I hate revival. It just erupts. It's hardly controllable. At the Azusa Street outpouring, things got rough.
Yes, sir, and when the charismatic movement hit, sir, we were jumping out of windows. You know, we'll all end up to untie my bow tie, who stole all my Honda stuff.
Then I'll come in like a flood.
But they'll say that the Spirit of the Lord will lift up a standard against you. Sir, it's written in the Word.
I'll form weapons against them.
But, sir, no weapon formed against them shall prosper! It's in the Bible, too.
Yes, I've heard. I'll hit them with every filthy, lusty thought you can imagine.
But it is written, resist the devil, and he must flee!
Seriously than we are.
This is very dangerous, sir. Especially for me.
It's time to launch my final most vicious attack.
What's that?
I'll remind the saints of their past.
Their past?
How they were liars, cheaters, manipulators, and moochers.
Sir, you know what will happen if you remind the saints of their past.
And what is that?
Sir, they'll just remind you of your future! Until their level, for the sentence trusted in the Bible. Fasten your seatbelt, saints of God. The world is breaking forth in a revival.
The Holy Ghost is moving like a hurricane. Revival
is coming to our shores. Get ready for the movement of the Spirit. Somebody say revival. Coming to our land.
Holy Ghost is moving like a hurricane. Revival
is coming to our shores. Get ready for the movement of the Spirit.
Somebody revival. Coming to our land.
Holy Ghost is moving like a hurricane.
Revival is coming to our shores. To Spain, from Mexico, to China, the Spirit of God is being poured out on all flesh, and there is revival in the land! How many know God's bringing revival to Indianapolis here tonight?
Sense the presence of God in here tonight. Can you?
I feel Jesus.
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 In this place.
In this place.
Yes, my soul does.
My soul does
burn within me,
burn within me.
I feel Jesus,
I feel Jesus in this place.
Matthew chapter 4. Verse 23 says, Jesus went throughout Galilee, teaching in their synagogues, preaching
the good news of the kingdom and healing every disease and sickness among the people. News about him spread all over Syria, and people brought to him all who were ill with various diseases. Those suffering severe pain, the demon-possessed, those having seizures, the paralyzed. And the Bible says, and he healed them, but not just healed them, but healed them all. Now the scripture says of Jesus Christ that he is the same yesterday, today, and what? And forever. Isn't it great to know that the same Jesus that did these great miracles 2,000 years ago is the same Jesus that can duplicate it again here tonight in Indianapolis? The Bible says that there were those there that had severe pain. Maybe there's some of you here tonight that have severe pain. Maybe it's in your body. Yes, the Lord can touch you. God can heal you in your body, but maybe it's even more than that. Maybe it's severe pain in your life or in your emotions. Maybe your heart's been shattered in 1,000 pieces and you don't think it'll ever come back together. I want you to know that Jesus is the mender of the brokenhearted. The Bible says that God will inhabit the praises of his people. Can we give him something to inhabit here tonight? Come on, I feel Jesus, everybody.
I feel Jesus.
I feel Jesus. Praise him and say, I feel Jesus in this place, in this place. Yes, my soul, yes, my soul does burn within me, burn within me. I feel Jesus, I feel Jesus.
About 10 seconds. You got 10 seconds in you.
say Jesus is. Say it again, Jesus is. Look at somebody around you, poke him and said, I said Jesus is the best thing that has ever happened to me. If you believe that, give God the praise one more time tonight. Well, there may be another style of music I think you might like here tonight. I'm not sure. Anybody like country music in the house? They said I'd never make it. They said I would not last a day. Hey cowboy, how you doing? They said when things got heated up, I would get blown away. But I'm still here, Lord, still strong, and I'm still holding on every day, holding on every way. George Washington, Thomas Jefferson, Samuel Adams, First Chief Justice John Jay, names synonymous with the spirit of our country, founding fathers of the USA. Over 200 years ago, they shook off the chains of tyranny from Great Britain by divine call. Citing 27 biblical violations, they wrote the Declaration of Independence with liberty and justice for all. Well, something happened since Jefferson called the Bible the cornerstone for American liberty, then put it in our schools as a light. Or since Give Me Liberty or Give Me Death, Patrick Henry said, our country was founded on the gospel of Jesus Christ. We eliminated God from the equation of American life, thus eliminating the reason this nation first began. From beyond the grave, I hear the voices of our founding fathers plead. They're saying, you need God in America again. How many know what I'm talking about here tonight? You know what I'm talking about? Of the 55 men who formed the Constitution, 52 were active members of their church. Founding fathers like Noah Webster, who wrote the first dictionary, could literally quote the Bible, chapter and verse. James Madison said, we've staked our future and our ability to follow the Ten Commandments with all our heart. These men believed you couldn't even call yourself an American if you subvert the word of God. in his farewell address, Washington said, you can't have national morality apart from religious principle. And it's true. Because right now we have nearly 150,000 kids carrying guns to these war zones we call public school. In the 40s and 50s, student problems were chewing gum and talking. In the 90s, rape and murder are the trend. The only way this nation can even hope to last this decade is to put God in America again. The only hope for America is Jesus. The only hope for our country is Him. If we repent of our ways, stand firm and say, we need God in America again. How many know what I'm talking about here tonight, you know? Abe Lincoln said the philosophy of the schoolroom in one generation will be the philosophy of government in the next. So when you eliminate the word of God from the classroom and politics, you eliminate the nation that word protects. America is now number one in teen pregnancy and violent crime, number one in literacy, drug use, and divorce. Every day a new holocaust of 5,000 unborn die, while pornography floods our streets like open sewers. America's dead and dying hand is on the threshold of the church, while the spirit of Sodom and Gomorrah vex us all. Now when it gets to the point where people would rather come out of the closet than clean it, it's the sign the judgment of God is gonna fall. If there's ever been a time to rise up, church, it's now. And as the blood-bought saints of the living God proclaim, that it's time to sound the alarm from the church house to the White House and say, we want God in America again! I believe it's time, America, to stand up and proclaim that one nation under God is our demand. And send this evil lifestyle back to Satan where it came from. Let the word of God revive our dying land. For Jesus Christ is coming back again in all His glory, and every eye shall see Him on that day. That's why a new anointing of God's power is coming on us to boldly tell the world you must be saved. Because astrology won't save you. Your horoscope won't save you. The Bible says these things are all a farce. If you're born again, you don't need to look to the stars for your answers. You can look to the very one who made those stars. History tells us time and time again, to live like there's no God makes you a fool. Look, if you want to see kids live right, stop handing out condoms. Start handing out the word of God in school. For America is Jesus. Somebody say the only hope for our country is Him. If we repent of our ways, stand firm and say, America again. Can you see the only hope of America is Jesus? The only hope for our country is if we repent, if we repent of our stand firm and say, we need God in America. Jesus Christ, His only Son, and the blessed Holy Spirit, distinct yet three in one. And I believe there is forgiveness for everything we've done. That is why all the more I will serve Him. I believe the Son of God is crucified upon a tree, laid within a borrowed tomb, not far from Calvary. I believe he rose up from the grave, alive, for all to see. That is why all the more I will serve him. And I have made my decision. I've staked my claim. I've drawn a line in the sand. I won't be ashamed. With the world behind me and the cross before, by the grace of God, I will serve the Lord. How many know what I'm talking about here tonight? I believe you must be born again. John 3:16, do you know that it's true? The old life can be washed away. Everything made new. And I believe the love of God can somehow find its way to you. That is why all the more I will serve him. And I have made my decision. I have staked my claim. I've drawn the line in the sand, and I won't be ashamed. Where the world grace of God, I will serve the Lord. And I know when Satan and his minions come to torment me, when I invoke the name of Jesus, every demon has to flee. And I know the time will come when Christ returns again someday. Till then, there's just one name on earth whereby men can be saved.
There are many of you here tonight that have never made a decision to serve the Lord and make Jesus Christ the Lord of your life. What I'm going to do is ask you to do something that I did 18 years ago that radically changed my life forever, and that's make a public confession of faith to the Lord Jesus Christ. Jesus says, if you will confess me before men, I will confess you before my Father which is in heaven. If you will deny me before men, I will deny you before my Father which is in heaven. Jesus Christ is the only way. No man can get to God except it be through him. He is the way, the truth, and the life, and the only way to get to God. What we're going to do is we're going to open up the perimeters of this stage as we have done so many times before. If you've never been born again, never made Jesus Christ the Lord of your life, as we begin to sing, I'm going to ask you to make your way out into those aisles and come on down here to the edge of this platform, and I'm going to pray with you.
We have made our decision. We have stayed.
How many have made your decision to serve the Lord here tonight? The Bible says all the angels in heaven rejoice when there is but one soul saved. There were hundreds of souls saved here tonight. Are you ready to rejoice with me here for what God is?
Now's the time to celebrate when the Lord's your choice. Now's the time to celebrate and make a joyful noise. Now's the time to celebrate when the Lord's your choice. Now's the time to celebrate and make a joyful noise.
Come on, now's the time to celebrate, ain't it? Here's a jam going across the land, and the jam, and I think you know, it's a groove on the move, and the groove you've heard from the word called the 150. Now this book on song may look all calm, but it's anything y'all but mild. It's all about praise with the big band plays, and it makes the saints go wild.
Now's the time to celebrate when the Lord's your choice. Now's the time to celebrate and make a joyful noise.
Let me hear you sing.
Now's the time to celebrate when the Lord's your choice. Now's the time to celebrate and make a joyful noise.
Come on, make a joyful noise here. God is worthy of all. With a harp and the lyre, everyone can hear how the praise of the Lord will come through. The strings, the brass, the cymbals crash, and the people clap their hands. But the spirit's right, and with all their might, everybody starts to dance.
Now's the time to celebrate when the Lord's your choice. Now's the time to celebrate and make a joyful noise. Now's the time to celebrate when the Lord's your choice. Now's the time to celebrate and make a joyful noise.
Let the people sing. Let the people dance, let the people sing, lifting holy hands. Let the people sing, let the people dance, let the people sing, lifting holy hands. Let the people sing, let the people dance, let the people sing, lifting holy hands. Let the people sing, let the people dance, let the people sing. He's a lion, thief, and rattlesnake, and he's broken every law. He's terrorized the lives of men, and he's under arrest because I've been sent with a warrant from the body of Christ.
What's how that warrant said?
It says, Satan, bite the dust. How many want to chase a few demons out of this town here tonight? Every one of you unclean spirits, I'm running you out of town. Depression, strife, disease, and fear, your posse's going down.
Oh, that's dinner for the dog, that man. We sent him over the box.
But I know who I am through Jesus Christ, so I talk to you demons like dogs. Satan, you coward, you monster of souls, I command you to appear. You're hiding from the presence of God, but I can feel you.
your fear from here.
You out of my key boy long enough, you got something in your crawl.
Yeah, praying church wants you to know.
No.
Devil, your kingdom is gonna fall. Cause I represent a whole new breed of Christian of today. And I'm authorized and deputized to blow you clean away. I got a message to deliver from one who's true and just. Well, spit in your eye, you father of lies, Satan. Bite the dust. How many want to see the devil bite the dust here tonight? You want to see that?
Boy, you gonna take me on in my unholy herd.
Not only take you on, but take you out by the Spirit and the Word. One by one, you'll drop like flies and the foot into the ground. Because greater is he who is in me than the snake I'm staring down. You demon of alcoholism, you'll be the first to go. There's deliverance from you through Jesus Christ, so hit the road. You spirit of infirmity, you ain't welcome here no more. Hands on the sick and they recover, so out the door. You demon of false religion, you prayed on mine so simple, I bind the spirit of your soul.
Oh, now, now.
Play that in your temple. Now, Satan, you're next in line. I'm gonna hit you where it hurts. Cause I'm tired of you and my family, and I'm tired of you and my church. I'm not my own, I'm bought with a price. I'm a Holy Ghost-filled man, and I'm tolling the bell of your eternal destruction across the land. Cause I represent a whole new breed of Christian of today. And I'm authorized and deputized to blow you clean away. I got a weapon with two bullets that overcome all sin and crud. One bullet is called the word of my testimony, and the other one's called the blood. Satan, bite the dust. Bite the dust. Well, how do you feel about that, devil?
I'm a feeling mighty
good. Christ is Lord, and God's still on the throne. There's power in the blood, and I'm saved to the bone. The devil comes against me, ha, he gonna feel some pain. I can bind him, bruise him, cast him out by the power of Jesus' name. No longer on the outside, on the inside I now stand. I'm sold out the whole route, completely born again. I believe on a third day, Jesus, he rose from the grave. The world thinks I'm crazy. I am just radically saved. Choose you this day. Tell me, who will you serve? Now's the time to stand up. You gotta let your voice be heard. You gotta come out from among the rest. You gotta tell the gospel tale. You tell them black is black and white is white, and hell is hot, sin ain't right. God is holy, Christ is coming, and righteousness will prevail. I'll tell it to you once, I'll tell it to you twice. The only thing that's gonna change this world is the gospel of Jesus Christ. Wimpy saints won't survive in spiritual warfare. If you know that Jesus is the only way, well, let me hear somebody say, yeah! On the inside we now stand. We are sold out the whole route. Anybody here born again? I believe on a third day Jesus rose from the grave. The world thinks we're crazy. Our friends think we are crazy. This whole city thinks we're crazy, but we are what?
Jesus Christ, he's away.
The solution to pollution of the mind and problems with sin. For 2,000 years, you still you must be born again. Oh yeah. Now tell me who, tell me who's in the house.
J.C.
Yo, tell me who's in the house.
J.C.
Tell me who's in the house.
J.C.
Yo, tell me who's in the house.
J.C.
Come on. Jesus Christ is in the house. Is J.C. in your house? Who do you go to? Oh, when the road is long. Brother, who is the answer when things are going wrong?
Jesus.
His name is
Jesus.
Somebody said
Jesus.
He's bread for the hungry,
Jesus.
The Holy One,
Jesus.
Water for the thirsty,
Jesus.
God's only Son,
Jesus.
Strength to the fearless,
Jesus.
Forever man,
Jesus.
All creation, when he's in your life, you want to dance.
Praise his name. We ain't done, just begun. Come on, son, it's hard to have some fun.